Hello everyone and thank you so much for watching. My name is Mila, welcome to my channel. I'd absolutely love it if you would subscribe to my channel, like this video and activate the notification bell. So guys, I'm gonna make you my top 10, more or less, fragrances for this winter. Seriously, get them. And yeah, before that, okay guys, this video is sponsored by Lily Silk. It is one of the best silk companies. They do a little bit of everything. They do bedding, they do beautiful shirts, as you can tell, and they also do pajamas and literally everything you can imagine made out of silk. Also, they are very, very affordable. They have sales going on right now. They make a great gift for Christmas. I absolutely love the packagings they come in. Look, this is just so cute. Not only they have sales going on, but you can also get 12% off by using the code MILA12. I will put it here. And also, all the items that I have talked about in this video will be linked in the description. So, Lily Silk is made out of mulberry silk, which is amazing for your hair, for your skin. It doesn't absorb the moisture, which means that your skin stays more plumped and your hair doesn't become dry. I have three items to show you from them. So, basically, what happens is that when you have a silk cushion, it doesn't pull on your hair and it doesn't pull on your skin, unlike cotton does, and also cotton takes the moisture of your skin. I literally noticed a big difference in my skin since I use silk pillowcases, and I will never use anything else, that's for sure. And here I have a pillow to show you. This is the biggest size and I have it in black. And let me tell you, it's very, very heavy. Look at the texture of it. It's so soft and silky. I mean, that's just amazing. And this pillow is absolutely huge. I absolutely love silk. It's the best material ever. Then I have scrunchies. Okay, I absolutely love to sleep with scrunchies. This kit comes with four different sizes. So I have the tiny one that I would more use like for ponytails. And then I have a medium one that I would use for sleeping. And I have two big ones, one bigger than the other. And these ones would be just amazing for top buns. Honestly, well, this is how it would look. The thing is that I have hair extensions in and I'm literally gonna rip them out if I put it now. Basically, they protect your hair when you sleep and they're also very, compared to, you know, the fake polyester silk. By the way, I would really not advise you to have bedding with polyester silk. And like, I don't even know why you follow me if you have polyester silk bedding, because it's a bit, I mean, like, cheap. And then I have this shirt that I absolutely love. So I took size M, and yeah, it's again, it's going to be linked in the description, and it is about this length. Honestly, I would not wear it like this. And you know what, actually, for a funny story, it's not funny, but I mean, it's a story. When I was about 23 years old, my signature look was like a silk shirt with a skirt. I'm going to show you what kind of look I'm talking about. And I think it's the best look. Honestly, if there is one look I could choose, it's a shirt with a mini skirt and high heels. I'm going to show you. And by the way, did you see this gold detail? It's absolutely amazing. On one side is a pearl and on the other side, it is just like a gold pearl. Okay, so this was like my signature favorite look. I have leggings underneath, don't pay attention. So I would wear it like this. So it would make my boobs pop. Then it cinches your waist. And obviously I put the shirt inside and the skirt is quite short, as you can tell. So guys, go check out Lily Silk. They have amazing deals going on. They're amazing for Christmas. Also check out for Black Friday because they have amazing sales. And with MILA12 on top, you just get a great discount. Okay, let's continue with the video. And I'm gonna start by the ones that I think I talked the least about. So one of my favorite fragrances and that I'm wearing today is Kiali Deja Vu White Flower 57. So this is an amazing jasmine, orange blossom, kind of classic perfume. I think that this would suit amazingly classy women. It could all also be like a signature scent, but I feel like it's just amazing for winter. And also I have the hair mist, and I used it today, and I, you know, I was so excited to use it that I actually blow dried my hair before putting my makeup on. And trust me, blow drying my hair is so annoying. I hate it. I think it's one of the things I hate the most about life, blow drying my hair. But yeah, I mean, being murdered would be worse. But blow drying my hair, to me, it's hell. It takes ages. It's annoying. And yeah, I don't even style my hair. I don't understand how girls can choose an outfit, put makeup on, and style their hair. To me, it's just too much. But yeah, sometimes I do it. Okay, let's not talk about that. So Kylie Elixir Déjà Vu, definitely recommend. I don't know how you can not like it. And it's very similar to Elisa Bleu Parfum, only I think it doesn't have honey. Honey is replaced by vanilla here. So yeah, it's very, very good. Very classic without being old school. You know what I mean? So you definitely need that. Should I throw it? It's 100 bottle mil, guys. I'm being dangerous and I'm gonna throw it far, look. Okay. Then let's do like classic, non-classic, classic, non-classic, classic, okay? So then my favorite Eau de Toilette Hypnotic Poison. Did I tell you everything will be linked in the description as usual, as always? So I was wearing this yesterday. It is a bitter almond vanilla perfume. And I think it is just amazing. I love it for absolute years. And I have this bottle for years as well, but I use it so sparingly because I heard that they reformulated it. Tell me, is it true? Is it a fact? Is it lies? Because everyone loves to lie about stuff. So yeah, bitter almond. I don't know, this bitter almondness is just like, it gives it a touch of originality because of the fact that it's bitter and sweet, and it's a gourmand perfume, I forgot to mention. It means that it's that it has edible notes in it, which is just good. Then Jousset Gourmand Bac Hor. I love this. This was sent to me and I absolutely love it. I wear it all the time. It's a sticky, to me it smells like sticky caramel, basically. Sticky Sunday caramel. It literally, like, seriously guys, believe me. You know McDonald's, the Sunday caramel with the liquidy caramel. Imagine this liquidy caramel and to me it smells like this. It probably has heaps of other notes, okay? But to me, like, I don't know, maybe it's a childhood memory and or something, but to me, it's literally this. Literally this. Then what do I have? Okay, so I put some mainstream perfumes here and there. This is Elisa Girl of Now. I would say that this is quite mainstream, but not too mainstream. It doesn't have almond. It smells like pistachio. Okay, and it's just very, very sweet. I think it's very sexy. I think, honestly, okay, let me be just honest. I think that men would not like it. I think boys would like it more, but just my opinion, okay? It's sexy, but you know it. I mean, it's not that sexy. Then something very sexy. Montal Intense Café. I have about 2 dupes for this. But I think that this one is the best. So this is a rose oriental vanilla coffee perfume. I think that this really stands out and this really smells expensive, original, and all of this stuff. I do not like the bottle whatsoever. By the way, did you see what I did to it? Look, I chipped it while I was throwing it. Jokes on me, huh? Then what do I have? There is no point mentioning that. I won't look. I'm gonna try to find links, but it's limited edition. It is by the way, I have my nose that is runny and I did not take any blow, I promise. Where is this coming out of? And by the way, I never understood the word blow, like why, like what's the point to blow on it, like doesn't make sense. Okay, so this is Alien Essence Absolue. It's a more incensey, vanilla version of the original Alien. And I think that this one is one of the most amazing perfumes for winter. I think I mention it every year. And most of you say that they cannot find links, but you can buy it on Amazon, I think. And Amazon is pretty, how to say, you always ask me, can we trust Amazon? I trust Amazon. I bought loads of perfumes on Amazon and I never had any problem. Then I have Swiss Arabian Cher Al Sheila. This is the only one I'm not gonna throw because last time that I already broke a bottle, okay? So Cher Al Sheila is a rose wood perfume. It is a unisex, it is very oriental and lasts a very long time. When I broke the full bottle on my floor, I could smell it a few months after. So yeah, the longevity is good. I think nothing from what I recommended here, apart from Girl of Now, it's not amazing, but nothing is bad lasting, nothing. Okay, then just to not put Olympia, I put Pyrexis. This is another one that I would say is borderline, mainstream. The only thing that sets it apart, so it smells mainly of like a sweet note of popcorn, but it also has some florals, and most especially it has a salty note that I smell, but it's not in the notes, I checked. But yeah, it's very similar to Olympia. Very, very likable, but with still, I think mainstream people would like this. Like people who don't like perfumes that are a little bit too out there or too sweet or too this or too that. I think that this is a good compromise. If you want a signature scent for this winter, go for that. Thank me later. Okay, so this, Dior Addict. This is the 2014 version. So this is super strong. It's a white floral vanilla perfume. I think that Dior does some of the best vanilla perfumes, in my opinion. Okay, I think this has gone off, but I don't care. I will keep it anyway. This is, yeah, as I told you, a vanilla white floral. But you can, it's clearly more of a sweet gourmand vanilla with some white floral background. But I just can recognize this straight away and I just absolutely love it. Every time I wear it, even the out-of-date one, I never regret it. I absolutely love it. It is amazing. Go buy it. Then, oh, okay. So, I put this because I feel like it's a classic, okay? It's a very, very good classic. It is Angel Muse. It's like a Nutella patchouli perfume. I am not a fan of patchouli and I have not worn this as much as the Eau de Toilette version that I much prefer, that has like a crisp note, but I still absolutely love it. And now I kind of fancy wearing it again. Okay, look, the last perfume is my favorite of all of them, okay? It is Nazomato Black Afghano. This is my favorite perfume. Like, I think that I have not smelled something apart from Jousset Gourmand Bacchor and some other ones recently, and also Montal Intense Café, that smells as good as Black Afghano, okay? It is a dry, oriental, cold perfume. I would say that this could be a signature scent. It smells like it looks, literally. It smells like it looks. It doesn't have sweetness. I don't see any sweetness. It's smoky, incensey, with a green note, apparently cannabis. You told me that, guys. My belly is like dying of hunger, but I'm not giving any food, okay? Because I'm on diet. I don't even know, because when people were describing that, I was like, yeah, come on, another oriental is just more expensive than the other orientals. No, guys, it is worth it. and it is only a 30 mil. And by the way, Nasomato, if you want to send me your other perfumes to try, with pleasure. And you guys, please recommend me other Nasomato perfumes, or is Black Afghano definitely the best? Because I think that this is just amazing. If his other perfumes are even half as amazing, I would get them. Just amazing, like narcotic. I would describe this in one word, narcotic. Okay, guys, go check out Lily Silk. They are amazing. Mila 12 for 12% off. And also, guys, please tell me, what is your favorite perfume for this winter? I would absolutely love to know that. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel, activate the notification bell. Guys, I'm thinking about doing something, but I'm not sure. I am thinking of trying to post double this December. I thought I would post every day, but we had some, how to say, personal issues that I can talk to you about a little bit in another video concerning, I don't want to talk about it, I'm gonna cry. It's nothing to do with my fiance, it has to do with someone else of my family, and it's just changed a little bit everything, so I cannot commit to post every day, but I'm gonna try to post, you know, like 4 videos a week. I'm gonna try, okay? I can't promise anything. Please subscribe to my channel, like this video, blah, blah, blah. I'll see you soon, guys. Bye.